Let's talk about Senator Payman now. She made some controversial comments. She accused Israel of genocide. Anthony Albanese said that was not in line with Labor's view of things. We've had Ed Husic come out and give her some support, saying it was a difficult thing for her to come out and do.
Mm.
What's next?
Well, nothing, apparently. I mean, as she said, from the river to the sea, that sounds like wiping out Israel. That's the most objectionable thing she said. The view is she's a young, impressionable senator that was under pressure to make such statements. But David Littleproud here, he caught me by surprise with another view. He said, look, this has happened in Britain. She should be expelled from the Labor Party.
If he had the courage of his conviction, he would walk in there and he would expel her from the Labor Party. That's what leadership's about. That's an abhorrent statement. Abhorrent statement. And I just don't see how her position is tenable in the Labor Party or in any committees that the Prime Minister has actually appointed her to.
You've interviewed the new Liberal candidate for Wentworth.
Yeah, and have a look at her in a second because she looks like a teal MP. I mean, I've got to be careful what I say here, but it's that sort of age cohort, that sort of look, and she sounds like it. But I sort of said to her, well, but how does it work in Wentworth with, you know, a Queensland right-wing leader against a teal in a contest? And her line is the one that I expect to get regularly trotted out. I think it's the most effective. That is, if you're not happy with the government, voting for a teal will keep them there. You know, the Liberal Party needs to win more seats. So this is her argument. You know, successful business, middle-aged businesswoman we're looking at here. This is the sort of person who I assume the Liberal Party will be looking to run in most of these teal seats, except Tim Wilson, who got pre-selected again for some reason. Here's Ro Knox.
The country and Wentworth is really looking for strong leadership. We've seen what happens with the Albanese Labor government when you have weak leadership. There's been fraying in the social cohesion, which is a key tenet of a multicultural Australia. And I respect Peter Dutton as a leader, and I think our seat does too. And my view is Wentworth wants to get rid of this Labor-Albanese government. And the only way we can do that, Andrew, is by electing a Liberal member for Wentworth.
She's got a tough job ahead, though, doesn't she? Of all the teals that have been quite successful and had some cut through, particularly on the economy, Allegra Spend is one of them.
Yes, and you feel that it needs to be a very clear change of government election to dislodge some of these teals, and we just look at those poll numbers. We just don't have that. The best the coalition can hope for, and it's a real chance, is getting Labor into minority government as things stand. Look, things can change. The Voice, we saw that. That was way in front. That ended up way behind.
Yeah.
That's one of the other reasons, Laura, that I think Labor would be wise to perhaps go to an election in November. Mm. Considering all the cost of living pain, the numbers are okay for them at the moment. They're not going to get much better by next May.
But if you get an interest rate cut, for example, early next year, and then go after, that'd work too,
sure,
wouldn't it?
Sure, but how do you guarantee that? I mean, it's going to be a month-by-month proposition. Yeah, it's going to be a month-by-month proposition to assess that.
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah, the economists. I mean, seriously. I mean, 1 minute last week they were saying no interest rate cut till the middle of the year. And then one unemployment figure, interest rate cut by the end of the year. Okay. You know.
But who's got it right? No one. Treasury doesn't get it right either. They got one thing.
Well, they
here
got
is,
the inflation at, forecast right for right now.
And look at the US though as well, and the unemployment rate. That would have given Jim Chalmers a little bit of pep last week, surely.
Yeah, but it's been sticky there, and we seem to be a few months behind. Look, this is again, I mean, no one's got a crystal ball except me on Sunday Agenda where I have a crystal ball.
Yeah.
I think as things stand now, no certainty around the interest rate cut, you go this year.
Well, they've given themselves the option.
That's right.
We'll see you soon.